Hello friends, welcome to Scala Deep Dive tutorial powered by Nautilus Inc. I am Divya Dua, working as a software consultant in Nautilus, and in this tutorial we are going to explore about Scala traits. Those who are not aware of what Scala is a general purpose programming language providing support for functional programming and a strong static type system. And in this first episode of Scala Deep Dive, we are going to explore one of the very good features of Scala, which is Scala Traits. The agenda for our tutorial is: what is a trait, how to use trait in classes, and how to inherit one trait into another. Let's begin with a simple example. Suppose we have a class dog. And in this class we have the method speak, which returns unit, so we have created a dog class in Scala. Now suppose we have a scenario in which we have to create another class cat with the same method speak. So those who have worked in Java, they must be aware of Java interfaces. An interface in Java is a blueprint of a class. It can have methods, and any class which inherits the interface can provide method definition according to the requirement. So what we can do is, where we have the scenario to create two classes with the same method, instead of creating that, we can have an interface animal that have the method speak, and we can create our classes dog and cat that can inherit that interface and provide the method definition according to its requirement. Now let's try creating an interface in Scala. Now we are creating an interface animal, giving an abstract method speak. Oops, Scala compiler has thrown an error. So how are we supposed to handle scenarios where we are required to define an interface? Scala does not provide any interface. How are we going to survive without interfaces? The answer is, we can use Scala traits. A Scala trait is just like a Java interface, or you can say Scala has interfaces, but they are not called interface, they are called traits. And Scala traits are even more powerful than Java interfaces. We will explore about it in future tutorials. Now let's create a trait animal. Which has this method speak, which returns unit. And here we are not providing any definition. So this time our code has worked fine. There is no error. Let's explore this a little further. Let's check what its bytecode look like. So if you look at its bytecode, you can see that the animal trait is in interface here. But why this is showing animal as an interface? We have created an animal trait, not an interface, but this is showing it as an interface. The answer for this is, under the hood, it is simply an interface with an abstract method speak. Since the speak method is earlier returning a unit, so the compiler has converted it to a void method. So we can conclude that Scala traits are just interfaces on the JVM. So we have seen what a trait is. In its most basic form, a Scala trait is just like a Java interface. So we are done creating our trait. Now let's just use this trait in our class. Now let's create a class cat. That extends this trait. So why are we using extends keyword? This is because in Java we were using implements keyword, but in Scala we have to use extends keyword to use our trait in the class. So now we will provide the definition for the speak method. So we have defined the class cat. Now let's create an object of this class. And now let's call the speak method using this object. We have got our result. So whenever we have a scenario where we are to use the same method in multiple classes, what we can do is we can create a Scala trait which acts like an interface, and we can extend the trait in our classes and can provide the method definition according to our requirement. This is what we have done here. Now let's see what its bytecode looks like. So if you can see that here, then it is showing that the class cat implements the animal trait. So under the hood, what is done is, since animal is acting like an interface on JVM, so our class cat implements the animal trait just as the case with Java interfaces. Whenever we are supposed to use the Java interfaces in our classes, we use implements keyword. And in Scala we were using extends keyword, but on JVM it is being replaced by implements keyword. So we have seen now how to use trait in our classes. Just as Java classes can implement multiple interfaces, Scala classes can extend multiple traits. So this is done with the extends and with keywords. With keywords is basically used to extend multiple trait in our classes, and we'll explore about this in future episodes. So the simple example of using a trait in a class will be class woodpecker extends bird with pecking. Here are some of the rules to extend trait into classes. If a class extends one trait, use the extends keyword. If a class extends multiple traits, use extends for the first trait and with to extend the other traits. This is called mixing, and this we are going to explore in future tutorials. And if a class extends a class and a trait, then we are going to use extends keyword before the class name, and we are going to use with keyword before the trait name. So we have seen how are we going to inherit a trait in our class. So now let's try to inherit one trait into another. So in Java we were using extends keyword to inherit one interface into another. So in Scala we are going to use the same with traits. So suppose we have a trait pet and we want to use the functionality of interface animal in that. So what we are going to use is we are going to extend animal trait in that. and this is done. Now let's see what its bytecode look like on here. So this says the interface pet extends interface animal. So now we know that under the hood the Scala trait is an interface, and just as in as the case with Java, we can use extends keyword to inherit one trait into another. So this is how the trait works. So at the very minimum, what we have seen here is the traits, Scala traits, are just interfaces, but this is not the only thing. Scala traits are even more powerful than Java interfaces, and this is what we are going to explore in future tutorials. We are going to see how we can provide implementation to traits method and how we can mix in multiple traits in a class. So the references for today's tutorial are these. There's a very good blog on Nolda's website about the basics of trait, and these are some of the books that you can refer to get more knowledge of traits. Thank you for watching, and for any queries you can mail me at divya.dua@nolda.in. Thank you.